Today we're going to learn about how to create an interactive video with different quiz questions that pop up throughout the video and different informational pop-ups throughout the video as well, and we're going to use a simple template. Let's get started. Right, welcome back. My name is Jeff Batt with Learning Dojo. If you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out previous blog posts. You can also check out templates in Articulate Storyline as well as xAPI and video templates. And this is where you can find the video template that we'll be working with today. You can also check out full courses on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 video. I've been doing video for years, and a lot of the times it seems like it's kind of one-sided, basically. So you watch the video and you consume it, but you don't actually interact with the video. With this video background, I've wanted to just make video more interactive, where as you're watching the video, different things pop up and it will jump to different spots as well. So that's why I created this template, this interactive video template. If you go to the template section on my website, and you go down to interactive video template and click on download, this will download the template. You can see it here on my desktop. Now it will have a read file if you open this up inside of a text editor like Sublime or Visual Studio Code, and you can see how to go in and customize the code if you wanted to. You don't need to go into the code. I'm going to show you a tool that makes it a whole lot easier, but you can go in and dive into more of that if needed. You can see the index.html file. If I double click on that, that will pull up in the video. And let's go ahead and watch the sample video real quick, and so we can get an idea of what can be done here. If I click on play, you can see little dots that pop up at certain points of the video. As soon as it reaches that dot, either a question or informational content will pop up, and then you interact with it or just hit close, and then it will continue the video. Now in the question, depending on if you get it right or wrong, it'll jump you back to different points of the video, or at least has that capability. You don't need to. But I'm going to go ahead and click on, okay, where can you download jQuery? Let's click on jQuery.com and click on submit, and it gives me the correct feedback. Now you can see it has a check mark, and it continues the video. And then as soon as it gets to another point in the video, it will stop the video and have me interact with it. So this is just additional information about the video. So if you want to pause the video and say, hey, did you know, you may want to be aware of this kind of thing. So I'm going to go ahead and hit continue here. And you can see that that changes to like a blue icon. And then now a quiz question, if I get it correct, it will turn green again. If I get it incorrect, it will actually show a red X. And so it keeps track of how things are going. Now I can't skip ahead. It will skip to the next quiz question basically. So you can see here, I'm going to go ahead and hit submit. That's correct. And then it will jump on. You can see that it actually jumped back. And the reason why is because I had a trigger in there to jump back if they got it correct, or, you know, if they got it incorrect, probably makes more sense, but just to show this functionality here. And you can see the last question, I'm going to go ahead and just see if I get it correct there. Great. Now, as you start to play at the very end, it's going to make the video small. It's going to show you the percentage of questions that you got correct if you want to try again. One of the nice things is this will actually send over to a learning record store as well. So you can get the reporting over to a learning record store, and I'm going to show you how to do that. Now, to do this, you could, there's two different ways that you can edit this template. The first way is you can actually open this folder up inside of a text editor. Inside of this text editor, and this is the harder way, but it's the more flexible way, but inside of the text editor, you can go in and you can customize to your heart's content. So here's my text editor. I'm going to go ahead and pull up the index.html. I probably don't want to edit anything just to not mess up the code here. But if I go into the scripts folder and then go into the config.js, this is where I can see the title, and this is where I can update the title of the video. This is where I can update the description. This is where I can update to what video it's pointing to. Because right now, let's go back to that folder. Right now, that video is pointing to this right here, the sample-vid.mp4. And then the sample poster is what shows up before the video plays. And I can change that here. Now, if I wanted this to send over to a learning record store, I can put in the endpoint, I can put in the username, and I can put in the password as well. Now, inside of the markers, this is where it will show up in index, that means the first one. At what time, 5 seconds, it'll show up there. quiz question, main text, the possible choices, and then you can come down to the feedback where you can see correct and incorrect. Now this continue action is where you can either, you know, log something, or you can see here this function of navigate to time. This will jump back to 5 seconds if you wanted to. So if they got it incorrect, you can navigate them back to 5 seconds, and so they have to review the video again. So it has that capability inside of here. Now you can see the informational point there as well. Now this is all using JSON formatted information. So if you're familiar with JSON, you can go ahead and you can update this. You can add, I could copy this if I wanted to add another one at 20 seconds and have that information there. You may be thinking to yourself, Jeff, that's way too much code. I am never going to do that. Well, that's why we have a beta tool for you to be able to use to make this a whole lot easier. And I'm going to show you that here in a second. So the beta tool basically creates this config.js. So it's not a tool where you can like save a project or, you know, adds things inside of a project. It just works with local information, so no information is actually being sent over. So keep that in mind, but it's at least a tool to allow you to create the config.js without you having to go into the JSON. Now you can get to this tool by going to learningdojo.ninja/video builder. It's gonna cache information, so keep that in mind, but it's not gonna save your project, so keep that in mind as well. However, you can upload a config file that you've already made. So let's say you've downloaded that config file, you can always upload that, like right here, upload that config file and start from there. So it's, and we've thought about creating this as an interactive tool and everything, but that's a little bit of ways away. So, all right, so the first thing I wanna do is I wanna give this a title. I have a new video here called sample.mp4. This is a video, a previous blog post that I just want to add some additional content to, some different interactivity to. So let's call this sample video, and I'm gonna add a description. In this sample video, we cover the following topics. All right, now this is a video. It tells you kind of the example pathway. So it's going to go into assets and then find that. I'm going to say ./. So it's going to start from the parents, assets/, and I'm going to place that video inside of the assets folder. Now this video's name is sample.mp4. So I'm going to grab that exact name. It has to be the exact name here, and I'm going to paste it right there. If I'm going to name the poster right now, if I double click on it and just take like a screenshot or something, that'll be my poster, and then I can just take that image and name it poster as well. That way I don't have to update the path. If you just drag and drop and replace that, that'll be your poster, what the person sees before they hit play. It's up to you. If you wanted to change it to a different name, you just have to go into the video builder and type in the name. Or you can just leave it as is, and it will just look for the poster. Well, let's actually place that just in case. I'm gonna say assets/poster.png. And I said poser and not poster, so poster.png. All right, do I want to show feedback after interactions? You don't have to show feedback, but you can have feedback at the end of the interactions just by enabling that. Show incorrect or correct on the timeline. So do you want the green check mark if they got it correct, or the red check mark if they got it correct, incorrect? Then you can do that. Otherwise, it'll just show a blue dot after they've completed it. So I'm going to go ahead and select that. And then allow question review. At the end, it's going to show the review, the questions, and the feedback. You can go in and you could review that. If you want to enable that, great. If you don't, just leave that disabled. Now, this is where I can enable xAPI. So I'm going to pull up Scorm Cloud. So cloud.scorm.com. I'm going to log in here. I'm going to go into the xAPI LRS. I'm going to grab the endpoint first of all. Go into my JSON tool, paste that. And then I'm gonna grab the key and the secret. So the activity provider, the key, and then this secret right there. Just copy and paste that, and there we go. Now it's gonna send over to xAPI when the first person starts the video, when they actually answer a question, what the answer was, and so forth. Now we need to start building out our different points inside of our video. Now keep in mind that this is not gonna save the project. We're only building that config file. This is just trying to make it easier so you don't have to go into the code and build out that config file for this to work. So I'm gonna click on choose, and we're gonna go find an MP4 file. Now I have that MP4 file placed inside of the assets folder here, this sample.mp4, so I'm gonna click on upload. And it's just doing this locally, but now I can hit play. And now, as soon as I get to a point where I want the question to pop up, so let's say, you know, I just reviewed my website, I want to quiz them on what they just saw. So I'm going to pause the video there and click on this plus icon. Now, when I click on the plus icon, it says exactly what, how many seconds it's going to pause, or at what point is this question going to pop up. And then I can choose either a multiple choice, a true or false, or informational pop-up. Let's go ahead and do multiple choice, and then we can see the label here, question one, and then the primary text, what color is Superman's cape? All right, choose one of the answers below. It gives me with two possible choices, so I'm gonna say blue as the first one, I'm gonna say red as the second one, I'm gonna add a choice, and I'm gonna say green as the third one. Now I have to select one, which one is correct, and then come down to correct feedback, and this is the overall label, correct, let's just say that, you answered correct. We'll say incorrect here, come on, and then hit save changes. Now it creates a point in the video, so I can just move my scrubber, and if I need to come back into here, I can click on edit, and go back in and edit that question as needed. So I'm gonna move my scrubber and let's add an informational point here. So I'm gonna click on information. And now I can just say, did you know? Or just, I'll call this info. Let's just call it info right there. And then the sky is blue. And then more information about that. And then hit save. All right, so I'm gonna add one more quiz question. So I'm just gonna drag this here. And I'm gonna add a true or false question, which basically is like a multiple choice, but there's only the true or false options. And then I'm gonna say the true or false. And we say the sky is blue. Answer below. And then I'm not gonna add correct or incorrect right now, but I'm gonna click on save changes. So as you've gone through and you've added your quiz questions, the next step is to download this config file. So I'm gonna go ahead and download either the minified or download the JSON here. I'm gonna download minified, and it's going to download this config file. So in the sample file that I've, again, this tool is only designed to actually build this config file. You still have to place everything and place your poster image and your video inside of the template. But now if I go into the scripts here and I just replace that config file and hit replace, now if I double click on this index.html, notice that it has my sample video here, it has the text. If I hit play, it's going to start playing my video. Now as soon as I go to that point of the video, it's gonna pop open my quiz question. So what color is Superman's cape? I'm gonna go ahead and select red. I got it correct, and it looks like when I downloaded it, I forgot to check again that it was, actually, one thing I forgot to mention is when you download this, let me come back into the tool. Whenever you upload the video, you actually have to reset these things again. I'm gonna do that again. So upload your video first before you actually enable everything here, and then come in here and click on download minified. And let's try this one more time. So I'm gonna go into scripts. I'm gonna just paste in that config.js. There we go. Like I mentioned, this tool is in beta, so it's still kind of got some kinks to it, but I'm gonna click on play here, and then it's gonna pause the video. There's my question, incorrect, and so you can see now I have the red X, so this is working as well. But let's go into Storm Cloud, and let's go into our LRS viewer, and let's go ahead and hit refresh here, and I think it's under my sandbox that I did. And you can see right here, example user incorrectly answered question one or question two. So this will pull from the title and it will pull from your website that you put inside of the config.js. So you'll probably want to update the config.js with that as well. If you go into the config.js, open that up inside of a text editor, this is where it will pull from that information. And this is all minified at the moment, but you can update that information here. And also, how do I get the username? The username is pulled right here. So if you wanted the user to enter in their name and their email, you can have that just enter in their name and their email, and that's how it grabs the actor. So definitely still in beta here, but it at least allows you to make the videos a lot more interactive and allows you to track quiz questions throughout the video as well. So let me know what you think. Like, is this working? Is it not working? What else do you want to see in this template? How can I improve it? Things like that. What other interactivity can I add to this video template that will engage the learner as well? Go to my YouTube channel and then on this video, just leave a comment and tell me how I can improve this. I'm really wanting to get this to a point where more and more people can actually use it. But you can go to my website and you can download the template right here, interactive video templates. And don't forget to go to learningdojo.ninja/video builder. And that's how you get the video builder as well. And if you like this, go to my YouTube channel and like and subscribe and hit that bell icon so you can be notified of any future videos that come out as well. If you also wanted to check out my courses, you can go ahead and check out my on learningdojo.ninja. You can check out my full courses on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Scorm, HTML5 Video, and more. Hopefully this was helpful for you and you enjoy the template, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks, everyone.